When a germ enters our body, the defense cells in our body usually identify it as a foreign object. To defeat an enemy, one must first recognize the enemy. That's what our specialized cells do. When the invasion occurs for the first time, our defense cells may not be well prepared to attack, and as a result, one can fall sick. However, these cells keep the germ pattern in its memory for a future defense if required. So, if the germ enters our body again, our defense system will be ready for a fight by recognizing the germ as an enemy of the body and start releasing antibodies to fight the invading germ. This is called adaptive immunity. Vaccines that are a form of weakened or inactive germ or a part of a germ induce a similar adaptive immunity. Vaccines make our specialized cells recognize the culprit even before it infects us. Thus, our defense system will be ready for a fight if we have been vaccinated against that pathogen. Different types of vaccines. First, we have the live attenuated vaccine, in which the vaccine is made from the germ which has been rendered weak by different processes before it is introduced into us. An example of this is the MMR vaccine. Advantage of a live attenuated vaccine is that the immune memory is longer than others. However, the main disadvantage is that we cannot give this for people with pre-existing health conditions like cancer, those on chemotherapy, or to those on various immunity-decreasing drugs as a part of treatment for the underlying disease. Also, the storage and transportation of most of the live vaccines is an issue as it may require refrigerators. Second is the inactive vaccine, which is basically a killed germ, either by heat or chemical treatment. Here, the memory developed in the specialized cells is not as good as live vaccines, so booster doses are usually required. Examples of this type are the hepatitis A and flu vaccine. Next group of vaccine is a subunit vaccine that includes recombinant, polysaccharide and conjugate vaccine. These basically uses parts of the germ which can be its protein, sugar or capsid. These vaccines also require booster doses. An example is a hepatitis B vaccine. The last type of vaccine is the toxoid vaccine, where a toxin made by the germ which causes the disease is used in the vaccine and immunity is developed against that toxin rather than the entire germ. This also requires booster shots to keep up the protection. The examples are diphtheria and tetanus vaccines. This concludes the type of vaccines in brief.